Now recording, recording has started. Now let us start. So we have done rational number. Just let me revise that. What is rational number? Yes. Rational number are of the form A by B. Correct. A and B are integers. And second condition, denominator should be non-zero. And second thing, the only common factor between A and B is 1. The only common factor between A and B is 1. Means their HCF is 1. Or whenever HCF is 1, we say that the number are co-primes. So GCD of A and B is 1, B is non-zero, A and B are integers. We have taken, seen the example 3 by 7, it is a irrational, it is a rational number. Correct. Now today we will see irrational number. Write on this. Irrational number. Write on this. Irrational number. Irrational number. Irrational number. So write on. Root P. Square root of P. Square root of P, then cube root of P, cube root of P, and so on, are irrational numbers. Root P, cube root of P, fifth root of P are irrational numbers, where P is a prime. You know the prime number? Where P is a prime number. So what are the divisors of prime number? Yes? So write down this, write down this. Write down. Root P is a prime. Cube root of P is a prime, where P is a prime number. P is irrational number. So these numbers are irrational number, where P is a prime number. Prime numbers are those numbers which are divisible by 1 and the number itself. For example, 3 is a prime, 2 is a prime, 5 is a prime, 7 is a prime, 11 is a prime, 13 is a prime. So those numbers are prime numbers. Then write down a non-terminating item, a non-terminating. A non-terminating. Yesterday we have seen terminating, terminating decimal and non-terminating decimal. What is there in non-terminating decimal? Yes. 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 The division after decimal never ends. A non-terminating and non-recurring. A non-terminating and non-recurring. Recurring means repeating. A non-terminating and non-recurring decimal is, decimal is an irrational number. Is an irrational number. A non-terminating and non-recurring. Non-recurring means the terms are not repeated. One digit or two digit or three set of digits, they are not repeated. For example, so non-terminating numbers are irrational numbers. You can take the example 0.42, 43, 445, and dash dash dash. So this is non-terminating decimal, and this is non-recurring. Is it clear? It is non-recurring because a digit and a pair of digit does not repeat. 42, then next it is 43, then it is 44, then it is 5, and so on. So this is non-terminating. So non-terminating numbers are blank. No, my dear. Now yes. It is very much clear. Just check the internet connection. Then the value of pi is pi. Pi, you take 22 upon 7. That is not the exact value of pi. So it is 0 point, it is 3 point, not 0 point. 3.14, 159, 9 and so on. So pi is non-terminating decimal. Mute the microphone, everybody. Mute the microphone, remaining student. So the value of pi is non-terminating decimal. So pi is also irrational number. Pi is also irrational number. If it is 0.23, then yesterday we have seen terminating decimal. If it is a terminating decimal. 23, 23, 23. So in this year, it is non-terminating. Okay, that is correct. But what about occurring? What about recurring number? This pair 23, 23, 23, 23. This is repeated, no? So it is not a rational number because it is, even though it is non-terminating, but it is recurring number. So it is not a, it is not a irrational number. Yeah. Let us take one example. Root 3. What is root 3? Mute the microphone, my dear. Who is there? Mute the microphone, otherwise I will unmute. Mute the microphone. Everybody will mute the microphone so that there should be no difference. What is root 3? Rational or irrational? Yes? What is root 3? Irrational? No, no, my dear. It is irrational. See this. Root p, where p is a prime number. So 3 is a prime number. So root 3 is irrational number. What about root 11? No. Root 3 is irrational number because see, you are telling me. Yes, you are telling me 1.732, correct? But this is not only 1.732, it is further, we are taking up to 3 digits. For our calculation purpose, we are taking up to 3 digits, 732. But it is non-terminating decimal. There are few further digits also in root 3. But for our calculation, we are taking only 1.732. Is it clear? So root 3 is irrational number. So it is non-terminating decimal and non-recurring. Then root 11, 11 is a prime number. 11 is a prime number, no? So root 11 is a irrational number. So root p, where p is a prime number, is irrational number. Now write down. Then we'll see. Then write down first point. The sum of two, we have seen. What is the sum of two rational number? Yes, yesterday we have seen, no? Sum of two rational number is always a rational number. But the sum of two irrational number, write down. Sum of two irrational number. Properties. हाँ यस आज बताओ वन मिनट यू आर टेलिंग मी 1/3 डिवाइड बाय सम अदर फ्रैक्शन 5/7 करेक्ट यू वांट टू डिवाइड टू फ्रैक्शंस नो ओके सो दिस विल बी 1/3 इनटू 7/5 करेक्ट सो दैट इज 7/15 सो नो माय डियर 1/3 दैट इज 0.3333 यस्टरडे आई टोल्ड यू दैट टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल एंड नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल इज इट क्लियर हाँ सो दिस इज टर्मिनेट सो दिस इज नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग करेक्ट दिस इज नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग बट दिस इज रिकरिंग नंबर यस और नो दिस इज रिकरिंग दिस डिजिट 3 इज रिपीटेड नो सो इफ इट इज रिकरिंग नंबर इट इज नॉट इरेशनल नंबर सो दोज नंबर विच आर नॉट इरेशनल नंबर दे आर रैशनल नंबर सो ओनली टू नंबर आर देयर रिमेंबर आइदर द नंबर विल बी रैशनल और इट विल बी इरेशनल सो इफ इट इज नॉट इरेशनल इट मस्ट बी अ रैशनल नंबर इज इट क्लियर यस सो राइट डाउन sum of two irrational number may or may not be an irrational number may or may not be an irrational number in some cases sum of two rational number will be irrational number sum of two irrational number will be irrational number in some cases it may not be irrational number let us illustrate this example where it will be irrational where it will not be irrational example I will take let me make it two parts a is root 3 and b is root 5 What is a plus b? What is a plus b? Root 3 plus root 5. And root 3 plus root 5. And remember this. No. We cannot say. See here. Root a plus root b is not equal to root a plus b. This you remember. Root a plus root b is not equal to root a plus b. I cannot add a and b if the roots are separate. Is it clear? Root a plus root b is not equal to root a plus b. So a plus b is root 3 plus root 5. Now what is root 3? Irrational. What is root 5? Irrational. So in this case, their addition is irrational. Root 3 plus root 5 is irrational. Let us take A as root 3 plus root 5 and B as let us take A as 3 plus root 5 and B as 3 minus root 5. Then what is A plus B? What is a plus b that will be 3 plus root 5 plus 3 minus root 5 correct now this root 5 get cancelled root 5 get cancelled what is 3 plus 3 6 a plus b is 6 and what is 6 rational or irrational rational because 6 can be written as 6 upon 1 so this is rational number This is rational number and this is irrational. In this case, it is irrational number. In this case, it is rational number. So, sum of two irrational number In some case, it will be rational number. In some case, it will be irrational number. So this is not definite. Like in case of rational number, sum of two rational numbers must be a rational number. But sum of two irrational numbers may or may not be irrational number. Clear? Then before we start that, so sum of two irrational number may be, may not be irrational number. Before we start, you write down this, that root A plus root B is not equal to root A plus B. I cannot take A and B together in the root and add them. Then root A minus root B is also not equal to root A minus B. Root A into root B, yes. Root A into root B. Now in this case of multiplication only I can take inside square root. That is root A into B. So then root A upon root B, I can take root of A upon B. So this result is applicable only for multiplication and division. Is it clear? But for addition and subtraction, I cannot take plus inside. So this result you remember, because when we conduct the exam, student write root 3 plus root 5, root 8, root 2 plus root 3, root 5. No. In case of addition, if it is root A plus root B, I cannot write that as root A plus B. That will remain as it is, root A plus root B only. If it is root A minus root B, it will remain as it is, root A minus root B. I cannot write root A minus B. But in case of multiplication, root A into root B, I can write root A into B. Then root A upon root B, I can write root A upon B. Is it clear? So this is not applicable in case of addition and subtraction, that I can take the number inside and add them, and I can take the number inside and subtract them. No. It is only applicable for multiplication and division. Is it clear? So sum of two irrational number may be irrational number, may not be irrational number. What about One minute. You are telling me that A plus B plus C. Then is equal to suppose 6. 6 I have taken. Correct. Now if you want to take root on both the side. Root on both the side. So root A plus B plus C, I cannot write as root A plus root B plus root C. Yes or no?